السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Wherever you are, whenever you are, today we'll have another visit with Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan and the foundation to Bosnia in 2005. After we had a very successful cow sponsorship or cow program with the organization, they decided to sponsor Islamic Leaf again in rebuilding the houses of the returnees to Bosnia, inshallah. And this was in 2005. And at that time, the chief executive of the organization was Sheikh or Ustaz Abdullah bin Salim al-Zahiri. He was a military officer in the army of Emirate, and he was from Jama'at Tabligh wa Dawah, and he was very, very kind and very polite individual, loving the charitable activity, loving Dawah activity, loving everything. He was a noble man. And he was always bringing us to his room, especially at Fajr prayer, during our travel together to pray Fajr together. Then he by himself, by his own hand, used to make the Emirati or the Arab coffee for us and give us a reminder in the early morning. And in this visit, he was wearing the traditional Emirati dress, the white one with the turban, with actually have a stick in his hand, and his beard was long but clean and trimmed nicely. And it was, I loved this man very much because he was very, very kind and very well mannered. And we were traveling with him to visit some of the houses which had been rebuilt with the partnership between Islamic Leaf and an organization from Germany called Kapanamor. They used to build the structure, the body of the house, and we used to bring the windows, doors, electricity, sanitation, and everything, and painting, and. This was a partnership. I did not understand why many photographers were there to take hundreds and hundreds of photographs for this man. Maybe they looked at his face and his dress as a stereotyping, and he was planning to do something. Okay. Next day we were leaving for, I was leaving for UK and he was leaving for Emirate, and I met him in the airport and he was in a shocking state. I said, what happened? He told me they put my photograph in one of the magazine called Middle East, Sharq al-Awsat, and underneath it, they linked my photograph to a terrorist group in Bosnia. And he was shocked because he received this from his people in Emirate. And I was shocked with him, but I'm trying to cool his nerve, try to give him more assurance that his organization will be with him and this is haram, let us fight back. But anyway, this reflects two things: unethical crook photographers and bad media outlets such as Sharq al-Awsat, or actually the Middle East. And here the big question is, United Nations, how did you allow those thugs who called themselves photographers to come and film and take a photograph of your guests or chief guests without vetting on them and knowing who are they? Actually, and this question has to go to United Nations as an organization. Lesson learned from here: in this difficult situation faced our brother, we have to be very close to him, be kind to him, spreading the good messages, and give him reassurance, and be with him all the time, and try to find good media experts to advise us what to do with that. And to go back to support him in his organization, and to go back to complain to the United Nations of allowing this kind of individuals who claim that they are photographers to come and accompany their guests. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.